Are you wanting to start off your IT certification journey and you're not really sure where to start? These days, there's certifications from Microsoft, CompTIA, SANS, all these different places, and it can be overwhelming at times. So today we're going to talk and see if CompTIA is a place for you to start. Hello and welcome back to the channel. I am TJ Houston, and if you're new here, welcome. On this channel, I talk about all things IT and how to get your certification going, your certification journey going, because my goal is to get you a job in IT. Today, we're talking about the CompTIA A+ exam. I want to go through the pros, the cons, and then talk about like what the certification is and if it's worth it for you to get this certification in 2023. And if you go till the end, I'm going to share some of my resources that I really enjoy that I use to prepare for this exam. So let's get started. Let's talk about the A+ exam. What exactly is it? Well, the A+ exam kind of falls at that entry level section of our certification pathway. Okay. So ITF and A+ are the kind of stepping stones in order to start off the CompTIA certification. Then you kind of spread out from there, whether it be the Network Plus, Security Plus, Linux Plus, Pen Test, all these other certifications that are there. But A+ is kind of the baseline that you start from. And there's two different exams that kind of encompass this certification. Okay. So you're going to learn things like hardware, software, operating systems, troubleshooting. You'll talk a little bit about databases and not necessarily like hardcore code, but you should probably understand pseudocode and stuff like that, or at least have an idea of those things, okay? And a lot of people say, well, do I really need to have a certification? And to that, I think you do. For me, certifications kind of open up that door for me because a lot of times HR departments are given a job description and they really don't know what exactly the job entails, but it's their job to find people that kind of meet these requirements. And if one of those requirements is the A+, and you could have all the knowledge in the world about IT, but if you don't check that box and have that certification, chances are you're going to get passed over. So certifications within the IT industry are super important because it kind of validates knowledge across, you know, what they're looking for in that job description. And one thing that I like about CompTIA is it's very generalized, okay? Other certifications like CCNA, for example, they're going to go a mile deep into Cisco and kind of how Cisco does networking. And you'll learn things like subnets and VLANs and the OSI model and stuff, but you're going to learn it through the view of Cisco, and you're going to have a lot of CCNA or Cisco level knowledge. Whereas the Network Plus, for example, it's very generalized. So when you get that job, you know, you're not picking a camp. If you were, you're kind of have good knowledge of how it works, and then you can apply that next layer of the individual. So in the certification, you're going to talk about Windows, you're going to talk about Mac, you're going to talk about Linux, but it's not going to go a mile deep into that, okay? So what are some of the pros of the CompTIA certification? Well, first and foremost, it's going to enhance your job prospects. Like we just talked about, you know, you have to check that box when it comes to that application, right? So that's what the HR gatekeepers, as I like to call them, not really necessarily in a negative way, but they have a job to do. And they were told by the department that this is what, you know, they need. So you increase your employability by having that certification. Also, that kind of gives you a little bit higher earning potential from someone that maybe doesn't have that certification, okay? So you're kind of that step above. And again, even if somebody has all the IT knowledge in the world, you have that certification. So yours is proven, where theirs, you know, they only know from kind of experience. So again, it can, especially if you're just getting into IT, it can be good to have that certification because you can kind of go for those higher level jobs. Another thing that's great about this certification is just how in-depth they go when it comes to troubleshooting, okay? So my full-time job is teaching IT and cybersecurity, and I have an advisory committee. And on that advisory committee, I ask them, like, what are you looking for when it comes to, you know, technicians coming to you? And the number one thing that I hear is that people struggle not being able to step through a problem, Okay. So people will look at a problem and be like, oh, I'll just try this. I'll try that. And then, you know, 5 hours later, they still really don't know what the root cause is. So that's one thing of going through, if you've never had to do any, you know, standardized troubleshooting or technical troubleshooting, CompTIA really reinforces that by, you know, establishing what is the issue, what are some possible fixes, and then methodically kind of working through those things. So this is one thing that going through this on your, you know, during that interview process, they're probably going to ask you, here's an issue. Tell us how you would kind of step through it. And because you have gone through the CompTIA A+, you've been kind of coached in developing your own methodology, you'll ace that interview because you've had so much experience with this. So again, really focus on that. Focus on building that troubleshooting mentality or troubleshooting methodology, not only for the test, but for your own sake, because that's something that will set you apart from people who maybe haven't focused directly on that. And that's, as an IT technician, you're a problem solver. You're going to get a help desk ticket that comes in, and you're going to be out there, you're going to have to come up with some ideas on how to kind of close that ticket and solve that user's issue. So again, that's one thing that I really like about this certification. Also, it's a very widely recognized certification all over the world. And also with the DOD puts out a list of like what certifications you have to do a certain job. And the A+ is on that certification list. So again, if you're looking for a government or contract job, if you are just looking for, you know, employment anywhere in the world, the CompTIA certifications are recognized everywhere. It's one of the most widely recognized certifications in the IT world. And it's also probably one of the most trusted benchmarks for your IT pro, especially in that kind of entry level, kind of getting into the business. Okay. So those are kind of some of the problems. Pros, enhanced job prospects, comprehensive knowledge of IT skills, and just the industry recognition and credibility of this certification. So let's talk a little bit about some of the cons of the certifications, because it's not all sunshine and rainbows, okay? The one thing that I see people underestimate the most about this certification is the amount of time and commitment that it's going to take in order to get this certification. This certification is comprised of two different exams. That's how much content it that you're going to be tested over. So it breaks it into two different tests. You have about 90 minutes for each of the tests, and they can be taken separately. It's not like you take test one and then immediately take test two. You can do that, but I like breaking that down into, you know, kind of compartments and showing mastery in those compartments in order to get those certifications. Okay. So be prepared to spend a lot of time studying and preparing for this exam. And towards the end of the video, I'm going to share some of the things that have worked for me and that I recommend to my students that are studying for this certification. Also, exam fees and how much it's really going to cost you in order to take this certification. You're looking at around $500 in exam vouchers just to sit for the exam. Okay. So again, that's a pretty big, especially if you're just getting into the IT world. If you're coming from another, you know, maybe you're set in your career and you have that money to burn, you know, it might not be a lot of money, $500 to kind of change your life and get into a different career. But, you know, for my students who are 17 and 18, you know, $500 is a lot of money. And luckily in my program, you know, that's paid for, where the school will actually pay for their certifications. And then also, if you're in the state of Ohio, there's a thing called Tech Cred that if you're employed at, let's say you're working for a mom and pop shop that's an auto repair store, you know, they can actually apply to get that certification for you because Ohio wants to upskill its workforce. And other states might have that as well. So in Ohio, it's called Tech Cred. And finally, a kind of a tip for the exam fees. If you do go to a university, if you sign up with your if you go through and sign up with your .edu account, you can also sometimes receive a discount on those, up to like 50% off those exam fees. And as always, if you need help figuring out how to pay for it, feel free to reach out. We can brainstorm some ideas. I'm more than happy to help you do that. Another thing that's kind of a con is the limited scope and depth of this certification. This is not an end-all be-all. You know, they're just looking to validate what skills you have in these certain areas. So you're not going to go a mile deep into, you know, every single type of database that's out there or every type of, you know, every Linux operating system that's out there. This is a very generalized a very generalized body of knowledge. So with that, you're kind of expected on your own, you know, when you get into your career, to kind of go that mile deep. And that's what I do like about CompTIA, is this is your entry level, and then you kind of branch out into those other certifications. Also, one thing that is kind of a con, it's a pro and a con at the same time. As someone that would hire, you know, IT support, I think it's a pro because it forces you to kind of always stay on top of your knowledge, and that's renewal. So this certification is constantly getting updated, and if you don't renew within the time frame, then your certification is no longer valid. But there's three different ways that you can actually update that certification. One, you can retake the test, which I don't really suggest. I mean, you're supposed to be like growing into your IT career. The second option is to get a higher level certification. So let's say this year or in the next 6 months, you set a goal to get your A+ certification. Well, within that next year, if you get your Network Plus certification, it'll actually renew your A+ to that date. So as long as you're constantly growing, your certifications will all stay up to date. And the final option is doing what's called a CEU, so a continuing education unit or a continuing education credit. So let's say you go to a conference, you can actually get credits for that to update your certification. Same thing, maybe you become a content creator and you want to share blog posts, or you submit papers, maybe work experience. Those are all ways that you can submit to CompTIA. You pay a fee for your CEUs, but that'll actually update your certifications. And I'm pretty sure, I haven't had to do it yet, but I'm pretty sure that if you do your highest level one, it'll renew all the other ones as well. So for me, for example, I have the CAS Plus, which is one of the highest level certifications that they offer. So that's the only one that I have to focus on. And the different certifications that are there all required a different amount of CEUs. So I think it's like 75 for CAS that I have to submit in order to renew that certification. So I linked a blog, or I'm going to link a blog post in this article or in this video, where it'll go to the blog post where I take all this and I expound it out. It's a couple pages long, and you can find all the links in there as well. So I want to talk a little bit about like the real world application of the CompTIA A+ certification. Like, what exactly does it do for you? First and foremost, it opens up jobs for entry level IT technician. So some of those jobs would be help desk technician, desktop support specialist, or a more general IT specialist. So this could be at a very large corporation. This could be at a grocery store chain. So here locally, we had a job not too long ago open up, and it was for a bunch of grocery stores, and they were paying, I think it was like 40 or 50K for this entry level job. And this is the perfect certification for that. So think entry level. This would also get, like, if you're looking at school districts, this will also get you into that IT technician role that you can then grow into sysadmin or technology director. So again, this certification opens the doors for you. And then once you land that job, you can kind of promote into that kind of next path. That kind of segues into the next point that I want to talk about, and that is building a foundation for further certifications. One thing I really like about the CompTIA certification, especially on the cybersecurity track, is it slowly builds on the information and knowledge that you're attaining. So like in the A+, you're going to cover a block of security content. And then if you go to your Network Plus, you're going to cover even more security content. And then when you get to your Security Plus, you're going to get a lot more. But going through and constantly doing more passes over that certification, they transition very nicely to give you that pathway. So this will give you that good solid foundation where you'll understand kind of how networks work at this level. And then Network Plus just stretches a little bit more, and then Security Plus a little bit more. So you kind of slowly build onto that. And this is a great stepping stone certification too for higher level roles. So once you get into, like I said, a school district, you know, this is getting you that on-the-job experience now where you can actually start playing with domain controllers or firewalls or filters, whatever that might be. And this on-the-job training now is going to kind of fold right into your next certification. So again, this is all about getting you into the door, getting you that interview, getting past those HR gatekeepers, so that way you can kick off your career in cybersecurity or IT. And then what's really cool, once you get in that door, a lot of employers have a way that they'll either reimburse you or they'll pay for your certifications from that point forward. So again, hyper-focus on doing really well at the certification to kind of jumpstart your career. So in conclusion, is it worthwhile for you to get the A+ in 2023? I think if you are just new to the IT world or you are transitioning from another career, absolutely. I think this is 100% worth your time. And then again, you're starting off your certification journey. So as you're growing, the certification is automatically just going to renew. So yes, absolutely. I do think that for the reasons that we talked about, all those pros definitely kind of outweigh those cons. And I think this is a certification that is very worthwhile. So what are some of the kind of tools that I recommend to study for the A+ exam? First and foremost is Professor Messer on YouTube. It's a full free YouTube course that is all about the A+ exam. He also does Net Plus and Security Plus. So you'd have no money out of pocket. If you watch those videos, you can kind of go through it. Another one is Mike Myers. He is phenomenal. I love his edutaining kind of style. You can find him on Udemy. Udemy does sales all the time. Total seminars is what you would look for. He also wrote a lot of the IT certification books for A+, Network Plus, kind of these entry-level CompTIA certifications. So very knowledgeable. And the way that he explains things, he uses a lot of like different blocks and different diagrams and really does a good job of explaining it kind of in layman's terms. So I can't speak highly enough about Mike Myers over at Total Seminars. If you do prefer books, I like Mike Myers' kind of all-in-one guide. It's a really good one as well. And like I said, I'll post a link to all these resources in the blog post in the comments. So thank you so much for watching. If there's absolutely anything that I can do for you, please feel free to reach out. My door, my virtual door, is always open. Feel free to hit me up in the comments below, or you can always email me at tj@tjhouston.com. Thank you for watching.